This is all the way from Malawi. I'm a huge fan of Malawi, trust me. So we want to have a conversation just to get to find out about the industry and other things right there. And also for getting surprise guest, our very own. But if you know, we should get to have a conversation with him. Yeah, per minute, come back, check our interview so that we can find out. Last time we had him, we were talking about their brand new song. But our main focus today is all on Ella and Juchi, per minute, pan all the way from Malawi. Boss, what do you want?
Tribuino gani?
Vindo vidi bwans?
Zinto zikuenda kani?
Yeah. Ah, sa titi chama buino pano pa Prime TV. How is Malawi, man?
Ah, Malawi is good.
Huh? Okay.
Yeah.
How's everything going?
Everything is going great so far, so good.
Okay. Let's do this. Let's go on a short break on the other side. We'll go straight to that music video from our guests. Pangono, chitkalizeche pangono. Then on the other side, we should get to find out more details. Chitkalizeche 1 minute so that you have an idea who our today's guest is. By Atu Vibes. Go check out for that song. It's a million views. Come on, my numbers. Trust me. If you get those numbers in Zambia and Malawi, when you get above a million views, it's something that we celebrate. How is it in Malawi, man? When you got a million views for that video?
Our industry, our Malawian industry. You know, it felt good, you know, I won't lie. Because I should be one of the few Malawians who've got like a million views on YouTube.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a thing that we are still struggling to, you know, to achieve.
Let's go. So we're still having a conversation with a brother all the way from Malawi right here, getting to find out. So you were saying something in regards with how it is a big deal to Malawi getting a million views.
A million views, yeah. Because you see, it's all in numbers.
Yeah.
Yeah. In Malawi, we're like about 90 million people. But then internet is not... It's not that much exposed in Malawi.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like we have a few people like that are being able to use the internet. So it's a thing that is still being introduced to the audience, especially YouTube. You know, a lot of people in Malawi know Facebook, you know, and maybe Twitter and Instagram, but YouTube is not really, you know, that. Known, it's not like really known in Malawi.
Is piracy also a big issue in Malawi, where you as an artist, you also feel like when you drop a song already the street one to, they're just having access freely?
Yeah, it happens a lot big time.
So how are you artists making sure that you fight such things, making sure that channel young and I have to take a gun drama?
Yeah, you see, our industry is still developing, you know. We're still getting there. We're still in that stage of learning things, you know. how things are done, like how things are done here in Zambia, how things are done outside there, you know. The process is low, I should say, but we're sure about it. We have how can I put it? We have companies like there is Kosoma. Nowadays, you're being able to get your loyalties from Kosoma when you drop a song. So yeah, but then when we talk about like raising money, getting money from our streams, it's a bit challenging because of the same issue, the internet.
I see you've been having quite a number of shows. The last time I saw you on your social media, you were performing at some presidential something.
There was
an event. Maybe you can just tell me about it and how you found yourself at that event.
Okay, so I was in Nino. We were running this other project. I did a theme song for that project. So when I was when we were launching it, the president was there as well. Yeah, so I went there, I performed the song, and then I also did Goo 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 and some other songs. And the president was like, "Oh, boy, come here." You know, I met the president. It was really nice. It was a good experience. So since then, it has always been like that.
You are getting amazing feedback in your country, man. People don't know this right now. I know you might look like a new artist in Zambia, but in Malawi, Kurikoche is Jayakuti, a king is respected from where he's coming from. Like, let's try to do a comparison when you are getting into the industry and the current state. How would you describe the difference?
The difference? Back then, you know, I was just, you know, this other regular boy, this other ordinary boy, you know, moving around in the streets, you know, knocking on the doors, you know, being in the studio with these other artists, these other friends of mine, you know. Nowadays, man, it's really hard for me, like, to be doing some other things, because it's more like as if my name is on another certain level, you know. Yeah, so I think that's it. That's pretty much it.
How many songs can we say, okay, these are big songs in Malawi that people are familiar with?
My big record, my first big record was, I did a song called Illuminati. And then fast forward, also did a project. I have a project, an EP titled The Book of Z. Yeah, it's well known. It has like about 7 songs in it. And then I also have an album, The Book of Eli. It's a successive one, you know. I also have another one, Red Flag. I just dropped it like recently. Yeah, it's also doing great. That's where Goo 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 is in.
Okay.
Yeah, so I have, it's a lot.
Screen, you know, people will be familiar with them in Malawi.
Yeah, like for the likes of from the Book of Z, we have Z, Zitaru, Zitai, Ziteke, Zirungamo, you know, all of the songs, they know them. From the Book of Eli, there is Maine, Honesty, Foni, you know. There is a couple of songs from that project as well that people are very familiar with. And also from the Red Flag, you know, there is Goo Goo Goo, Boza, you know, 4 hours, people are listening to those songs. Yeah.
There's something that I've been preaching about and something that I also want to get to find out from you. This is just a personal thing that I've been trying to preach as well.
Yeah.
I know later I should also get to find out from the other guests that we're keeping anonymous for now. I don't know if you have observed as an artist, there are some countries like Nigeria, also collaborating a bit with Ghana. There are also some countries like Tanzania, also putting some collaboration with Kenya. Now, I was telling someone, a colleague of mine, saying, I think it's high time that we might not know this, but for a fact that if we want Zambian music to succeed, we also need to collaborate with Malawi.
Definitely, definitely.
Because we have a common thing. Like, if we talk about the similarities.
Or even the language, more especially the language. the lifestyle, like we're very common, you know. Like that's how the guys made it, you know.
Yeah,
they had to collaborate, they had to add up their numbers, you know. Imagine Nigeria,
Ghana.
With Ghana.
Yeah,
that's a huge number, you know. That's how the guys made it. And
last time I had Gwamba all the way from Malawi, a hip hop artist. He mentioned something.
Our goat.
He's a goat. So I came through on the show.
Yeah.
One thing he talked about was the challenge, or rather, music from Malawi not showing on international TV stations.
Mm.
I can testify. I've seen quite a number of videos from Malawi.
Yeah.
Videos are on point.
Mm.
What are you guys not doing? This is a question that we also ask our very own artist in Zambia. Guys, why are we not getting our videos on Trace? I know your video might show maybe Kamozi, Kabiri, Katatu, but you're not getting heavy rotations.
Mm.
What's going on?
I don't know what is really the problem, but I think it's the same thing like we are saying. It's all about numbers, you know. Those guys, like let's say for example Trace, they have to get convinced, you know. They need to, like, before playing your song or before, you know, getting in touch with you, they sit down and they start checking up your numbers, like how do you do in your country, how do you do in some other countries. And when they see that the numbers are not adding up.
But you're doing well. Your video has a million views, man.
Yeah.
Looking at the population.
And also, I think it's all about, I think the links should be the links. So if you know some other links, please link us up.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's all about the network, which is going to give you the net worth from the network that you're going to be getting.
Yeah, your network.
Is your net worth. Interesting. So we're still having a conversation. The other thing I also want to get to find out, right now you're in Zambia.
Mm-hmm.
What is your agenda? Why are you trying to explore more with different countries?
Mm.
You're not just from Malawi as well. I've seen you. You've been spending a lot of time in South Africa. We should get to find out about that. But right now in Zambia, what are you trying to push?
In Zambia, I was here for a visit. You know, I was visiting my brothers. And also, I'm here for a video shoot and also a media tour. Yeah, so it's more like about, you know, just exploring. Yeah,
I hope your country has your back, man. I hope they're super proud. I hope so.
Yeah, let's hope so.
Are we getting more love from our very own, like in Malawi? Are they playing 100% on radio station, TV station? How's the situation? How's the music policy in Malawi?
Like Zambian music in Malawi?
No, I mean your music.
Or
like
music.
Artist music. Is it like 100%? How's the agenda from media houses?
Yeah, now we are doing amazing. We won't lie. Like, nowadays, artists are being able to get a million views, you know, on YouTube. Things are moving. Things are changing, you know. Things are improving. The TVs, the radios. Way back then, we had this other issue of urban music not being played on the radio or on TV. But nowadays, when you talk about music in Malawi, it's urban music, you know. Yeah. So there's a lot that is changing. Yeah, and we are very, very... The future looks very promising.
Let's do this. The surprise guest that we had right here, anonymous, we're keeping it anonymous right now. Kadionko Cheva, director. Ka video cheka jaka meti marizapo, ka mene kaza. Kawa Prince Love, na wa guest watu pano pa Prime TV all the way from Malawi. Kadionko Cheva, so that maybe you missed out on the song. And I've been saying this. Guys, you've been sleeping on this record. I feel like it deserves more numbers than it has, the numbers that it has current right now. Let's go straight. Kadionko Cheva, on the other side, we should get to continue with more conversation with Prince Love.
Black out media.
Prince Love.
Winnie Beats go crazy.
If you know Zimbe, baby, I'll be your soldier. Suza Vutigabo, Nagumakolo, Suza Puerelago, no. Jealous and you are only come with him. I really wanna settle with you. Is a cook on the manga, you and the way ever. My lover. Baby, Niko Gatile. If you're not Niko Gatile. Then I'm gonna go Yamule. But if you want it, I'm in love.
So that's basically the song that we're talking about right there. The first time we showed that video, Prince came through on this show. There's a camera party, my proposals end up on social media. I mean, it's a trending. I'll be nice, man. I won't get you in trouble. How are you doing, my brother?
I'm fine.
Vindu vienda bwanji?
Vienda che. Mwize.
It's a good. My international collaborations. Getting those international collaborations, man. I was talking to the artists that you featured, man. Yeah. I'm happy that you're also taking the steps of also welcoming them in Zambia.
Yeah.
I would also want to get find out from Prince Love.
Okay.
Initially, idea, yamen, some guys that no, you can still come through in Zambia. Mm-hmm. We do something in Zambia.
Okay.
How did it all start?
So it started with his management, and I can say we are like brothers at, right now. So I thought of his music, it's dope, I can't lie to you. And my music as well, it's awesome. So I thought maybe we should try, he should try to tap out to the Zambian market and we tap out to the Malawian market.
Mm-hmm.
So they started planning for how the tour is going to be, you know, for them to come here to travel from Malawi to here. So, and here, yeah. You know.
Please, can you tell your fans? I know the last time I saw you, your maps, Kandeke, yourself in Malawi, you guys went there. Can you please tell the viewers how his music is doing in Malawi? Maybe he's sitting in Skamba from without, you know. My Zambia is not a dad, but I'm not Zambia.
So, Eli Njuchi is big. He's big in Malawi. Not when I say it's big, like, it can fill up a stadium. It fills up, like, you know, big... should I say club? So
okay.
We've done a number of concerts.
Of concert, like is one of the happening artists at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So where he's coming from? Not forgetting, like he had a show in South Africa.
Mm-hmm.
He had a show in Jozi and
Cape Town.
Both the. The audience it was big.
Mm-hmm.
People they came through, and then they vibe. It was a sold out shows.
Mm.
Yeah.
So there's some few clips that I got on social media that I saw him performing. Maybe you can just run us through some of the events. There's a clip right now that is on TV. Maybe you can tell us what was that all about. Maybe if you can just play the clip and just mute the volume so that we get it from the actual artist. What was happening there?
Oh, that was Suffix.
Album launch?
Yeah, his album launch. Your Max was there, by the way.
Yeah.
No, not your Max. Was Pompey. It
Pompey?
Pompey.
Yeah. Pompey, yeah. Mm.
So I was there supporting my brother, my big bro, Suffix.
Okay.
Big shout out to you, man.
I'm in talks with Suffix as well, because we have that conversation that is pending. Every time it comes in Zambia, there's always that thing saying, we're going to have that conversation.
Yeah.
There's another clip as well that I was just researching before that clip, that other clip.
Okay.
That is something that we spoke about, is it? Was that the presidential one?
Yeah, so this was, I think, it should be the third one. You know, it was in Kasungu. Yeah. Okay, so you guys are doing your okay, yeah, that was in Kasungu. The president was on the other side, you know. And now the audience was waiting for me.
Mm.
Yeah.
Interesting.
No, it was crazy, man.
Do you sometimes sit down when you watch such things? Do you sometimes sit down saying, you know where sometimes you just feel like, I never used to get such feedback, mm-hmm. okay? And now it's like people, waziba nyimbo yanga A up to Z. Do you sometimes wonder?
Yeah, it's been a blessing all the way, man. It's been God. I won't lie to you, because I'm coming from a very humble beginning. A lot of people know me, do know me. You know, I'm coming from Lilongwe. I was born in Lilongwe. Mm-hmm. It's there. So I was coming. I'm coming from. How can I put it? Ghetto. I'm coming from the ghetto. You know, so a lot of people know me from the ghetto, and it's been a blessing, man. Being able to be here, being able to be in Zambia.
Yeah.
You know, and do these interviews, link up with Ajina Prince Love. It's a blessing on its own. Mm. Yeah.
Prince Love, we're talking about the collaboration between Zambia and Malawi, like other countries. I know we should get to extend to more other countries.
Exactly.
But it just doesn't happen in one day.
Yeah.
As an artist, is it an agenda that you're trying to push as well right now? This is why you're having other artists, working with other artists, you going to other countries to perform?
Sure, sure. Like that's the thing that I've been pushing and I'm looking up to. Like to work with different artists from different countries, yeah. So that you know, when you stay in one position or one circle, you won't grow. You know, going collaborating with different artists from different countries, the exposure it's gonna be massive,
mm-hmm.
yeah. And then you would get what we want, because believe me, there are artists like me. I don't see myself like, okay, this is where I'm going to be, like, I don't want to be on this level. You get, every day I think of doing something new, doing something big, see?
Yeah. Do you feel your song that you guys did together, I was saying, I don't feel like it deserves the views that it has. Mm-hmm. There's so much input, man. You had to travel all the way to South Africa.
Yeah.
Linking up with him as well. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm looking at the input, man. Like, are you happy after the results came out?
So, this is the thing about numbers, you know? Especially in my country, Malawi, you know? Sometimes we might say that numbers don't lie, but in my country, numbers do lie, like, way too many times. Have you seen Kwamba? You know, Kwamba was here.
Yeah.
Do you know Zizakala Be?
Yeah, yes, yes.
You should check it up on YouTube. It has, like, about, I don't know, like an average, you know, number of views. But that song is very, very big in Malawi. Like, it's everywhere, you know. Also, the same thing with Marry Me. That song is making waves in Malawi, man. People are jamming to it at the weddings, you know, in their cars. I also performed it at one of the weddings that I was booked, you know. That song is really doing amazing.
So my question still comes back. There's more piracy going on in the background, and people are not taking the right channel.
Exactly.
And if the right channel was given, I feel like you should have been getting more views on his YouTube.
Yeah, man. Maybe. Yeah, to say, how can I put it?
So the way it is, like, I'm going to agree with what he's saying. Like, at this point, we are in this time of, like, we are in the process where we are trying to push so hard so that people, they should be aware of the pilots to say, no, this, let's do away with this. This is the right way on how we are going to promote our music and promote our own artist.
Okay.
At the end of the day, people, they'll be there to say, this guy, he doesn't have money, he doesn't do what, but they are forgetting that in the foreign countries, let's talk about Nigeria, South Africans, they are benefiting from their music being streamed on YouTube. You get, when you get more numbers, you get more money as an artist.
You see? Do you sometimes feel like, since internet is now our thing right now, and most artists, Zambian artists, I'm giving my opinion based on the Zambian artists.
Yeah.
Maybe you can also chip in if you agree or disagree.
Yeah.
Do you feel because of the internet being available, there's less groundwork being put across from the artist. What I mean is basically, we all know how old artists like Wakudela Kopangono artists used to push music, physical submission to TV station, radio stations. Now it's like it's all about internet, and people are judging based on how many numbers do you have on the internet, forgetting that there's also groundwork has to be put in. Do you sometimes feel like that? Because I've seen, like you said, I've seen videos, less views on YouTube. Groundwork is the biggest song.
Biggest song.
You'd agree with me. There's a song called Baboyo.
Baboyo.
Yeah. Less views on YouTube.
YouTube, but it's big.
Go
on the street.
There are such songs that are trending, but we're going to by YouTube, we're searching for about 43K, maybe 30K. And there are some songs that have a million views, but the feedback is not happening on the ground.
Okay. Sometimes I would say, maybe they are not familiar with the artist, or maybe I'm with you driving, you're driving, I'm just with you in your car, you're listening to the song, I'll just do this Shazam, then I just got the song and just stream the song. I'll have it maybe on Audio Mac, on Boomplay, you know. I won't even pay attention to go to the YouTube and check out the video. Why? Because I'm not familiar with the artist.
Yeah.
You get, and I'll go back to the point where you said artists, maybe they are not doing more of the ground thing. You get. I think I would agree with you. Nowadays, I think things are changing. People, they are not. It's no longer, you know, what we used to in when Kambushita promote music, right? Would get songs like I'm fresh, Nzayamba. I would come to you, Abuela. Ah, Nareta Kuno, Nashaban. Now that I can even phone you, ah, brother man, I've got this. Can I WhatsApp you? Can I do what you get? I would do that. I would go to another presenter or radio DJ. I would do the same, you know, instead of us going following them so that. They can be that thing, you know. I think nowadays, vinawa bweda kopans compared way back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ellie, kamani na vantu banu pa Prime TV panu. Now you are our people. We are adopting him. I know Malawans are going to kill me for this. We adopted Namadingo. He's now our very own, also he's our own artist. Mm-hmm. You can also talk to the people. Chakwanu, chamene, chichewa. Kamani na vene vantu, wamu zambia. Mwauze, vane funa kuchitile nkoni, mwauze at 9, dine, wanu, pa Malawi ni pa neba, pa nineba. Samu kamani kuna vene.
You know, we are home. Like, I've been treated fine. Like, I've been treated. We know one billion. Salami. Yeah. Choyamba, Zinalanga. My name is Zinanga. My name is Ellen Juchi. You know, Zinalanga Lobadila. It's Chifunima Makalasi. I know that one will be hard for you guys to pronounce.
Chifuniro Magalas.
Magalas.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. Born and raised in Lilongwe, Malawi. You know, I'm an artist, a singer, a songwriter, and a performer. You know, follow me on Facebook. Follow me on Instagram. Follow me on Twitter. Subscribe to my YouTube channel, Ellen Juchi. And yeah, we'll be keeping in touch. Say so. Yeah.
So I hear that you maboda kuna kusebenza pa works. Maybe ngati pase ko to my idea like ni vichani bani msebenza lapo.
I don't think I have to mention any. Panova kantaika noga. Okay, so this is the thing about me. I like surprising people. I don't like telling people my plans. You've taught them your plans. People start, you know, asking questions. What is going on? So we are still doing some collaborations. Here in Zambia, I'm doing some collaborations with amazing artists here. I won't be able to mention them because you never know. You know, my project saying Sangaza Tege. But then, yeah, we're still pushing.
Give us your top three. Mazamela artist, and I'm going to go to Ashtabui. Apart from your maps and Prince Love.
And Prince
Love. Any other three artists that you are using, but okay, my guys were seven. Then in my Nimbo, I'm going to go to Malawi.
Oh, I'm in the words you are. I should say I'm in the words.
Yes.
These are my top. hey, gonna get in trouble. Okay, right now I'm listening to Chef 187. He's a
Brock Norungumbwa.
I'm listening to his album. There is also Mark II, Vincenzo, you know. We've also heard a lot about Chilewani.
Yeah.
You know, who else? I want Bidi Koma. There's a lot.
It was great having a conversation with you, man. Kadionko che karikons. Tipa na ma freestyle with Sabano ma Prime TV. Kadionko. Ndimo wa singa yungu. Ndimo wa singa yungu. Kadionko.
Hey, freestyles. Oh, Kabena, what if you can just do Marry Me, you know? It. What do you think?
We do Marry Me,
Yeah, I think I'm okay with it.
We start?
Yeah, I think I'm okay with it.
Let's do it. Where do we start from? Where should we start from?
From the colors.
Okay.
Baby, ndikukwatile, ifuna ndikukwatile, kena kundikunyamule, bachifuwa unditsamile. What about you now?
Palamina, baby, amu, baby, amu, baby, and
what about you now?
Palamina, baby.
Yeah. Let's go straight to that song.
Yeah.
That's been an amazing ride here, Ellie. Yeah. Wish you all the best, man. Thank you very much. Let's be in touch.
We're
collaborating.
Yeah.
Malawi and Zambia.
Yeah.
So no just in I don't know how we can make it. But we'll find my initial so that we stop saying shan.
You know, just combining it. Combining it and naming it as one.
As one.
Yeah.
Yeah. So let's go straight to that Prince and Ellie song. It has been an amazing conversation. Right here on Prime TV.
Thank you. Blackout media.
Prince Love.
Witty beats go crazy.
Nifuna uzive, baby I'll be your soldier. Suza butika hapo, naguma kolo suza pwere lago. No, no. Kaleza ndiwa uliku mutima, I really wanna settle with you. Nizaku konda monga iwe ndiwe ever, my lover.